Good evening.
As a courtesy to our singers who have worked so hard this semester, I would ask that you please all take out your cell phones and show them to me, and show me that you know how to turn them off. We haven't practiced this in class, but we probably should have. We need to make sure that we don't have any false alarms, as it were. The other thing I'll ask for tonight is that at the end of each set of music, when each choir is finished, for you to applaud at that time rather than in between every piece. That'll help the choir keep their focus a little bit better as well. So this is our ninth grade chorus. We are thankful and grateful that you are here to step out of the rush and hurry of this season to hear the work that they have done.
Some captive Israel.
Thank you. Seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, filling the air. Oh, how Himself for heavenly
think Gabe might be taking my spot pretty soon. But that's what you're supposed to do. As the freshmen and the women's choir make their way back out, I'd like to say just a couple thank yous real quick. First of all, to Catawba Heights Baptist for hosting this tonight, especially to Becky, Jeremy, and then our sound guys, Derek and John. It is difficult to find a space that will hold 150 singers plus all of the people that want to come and hear them sing. And so we're very thankful to Catawba Heights. So can we please give them a round of applause? Next, I need to thank everyone at East Gaston. My first day was November 22nd. It was the Friday before Thanksgiving. And we are blessed to have a wonderful administration and staff to help facilitate things, even when they're a little bit rocky. So to Dr. Bostic, Ms. Pennington, Mr. Biles, the whole counseling staff, everyone that has given me help or has offered help to the students, we are extremely grateful to all of you. Joey Dunleavy is the band director at East Gaston, and while I don't think he's here, I have to say a thank you to him because he was my sixth grade band director when I was at Greer Middle School. And so you have him to blame for this tonight, really. I want to thank again Eric Myers for playing oboe tonight and Justin Baumgartner for playing piano for us. Can we please give him a round of applause? I told the chamber choir when we sang Go Where I Send Thee, we might need to just go ahead and pass around the offering plate because we're going to have church. And Justin certainly helped with that. High school choral teachers, especially to Melissa Glover at South Point for letting us use all of their risers. South Point had their concert here on Monday night, and they were gracious enough to leave their risers so we didn't have to bring ours over from East Gaston and set up a whole set ourselves. So we're thankful for that. A special thank you as well to Tripp McGill from Ashbrook. I was a sophomore soccer player at Ashbrook in the fall of 2002, and we were riding back on the bus from South Point, and Mr. McGill was driving the bus for us that day. And Mr. McGill turned to me and he said, not while he was driving, I should say that, but he turned to me and he said, Peter, why aren't you in chorus? And to be completely honest, I had been a band kid in middle school, and there had been transition, and I decided not to do music at first. But Mr. McGill asked me, and of course, I said yes. We got my schedule changed the next day, and the rest, as they say, is history. So, Mr. McGill, if you would please stand for just a minute so we can thank you. To the chorus alumni, we have one more piece that we are going to do with combined choir, and then we will sing the alma mater. So I will ask, as soon as we are finished with the piece Freedom is Coming, that you come up at that point. Our final piece is called Freedom is Coming. It's a South African freedom song that was performed by South Africans during the anti-apartheid movement that really began in earnest in the 70s and 80s. It's made more poignant tonight as we are 2 weeks out from the death of Nelson Mandela. And so I've talked to the kids, Kenny Potter, who many of you know from his time at East Gaston, one of my mentors, came over and spoke with the chamber choir about his time in South Africa and hearing some of these songs. And we felt it was especially appropriate to close the concert with this. So that will be what we sing at the close, and then we'll have the alma mater. At this time, I'd like to ask Dr. Bostic to come up and say just a few words, and then we'll sing.
I I just wanted to welcome everybody here this evening and thank you so much for being here. I think this is one of the first times that I've had trouble finding a place to park and a seat. So thank you for saving me a seat. I want to thank all of the parents and the students for your patience throughout this semester. I know it has been a difficult semester. For those of you that don't know, Ms. Humphreys was with us at the beginning of the school year. About October, she started having some health issues and things that were keeping her out of work. And our students endured lots and lots of different subs. You pretty much a different one every day for a period of time in there. And I don't think any of them had any kind of musical background. And so they were doing about no singing for a period of time in there. And I know that was very frustrating for them and for you as parents. As Mr. Haley said, toward the end of November, right before Thanksgiving, he took the sub job and he picked it up. And I realized, I didn't know anything about him. He was, substitutes just kind of pick up the job and they come into your classroom. And I noticed that the students were singing. And then we got to day two and he came back and the students were singing some more. And so around that time, I knew that Ms. Humphreys would probably be out until at least Christmas time. And I said, will you stay? And he said, I will. And I said, okay, now we've got a few other things we need to talk about. There's a Christmas concert. And he said, okay. And I waited to see if he would come back the next day. And he came back the next day. And I said, and there's a tux order out there that we need to get straightened out. And he said, okay. And the next day I said, I think there's a dress order that we need to get worked out. And we need to make sure that we have a place to have this concert. And so kind of about every day, I was like, and by the way, and he kept coming back every day. And I have to say, over this past month or so, to be able to organize and get all of this together in that short a period of time, as well as to network the way he has with other schools and with other choral directors, as well as band directors. Thank you for being here, Mr. Myers. I was shocked to see Mr. Myers from Mahaly Middle School here, that he even talked to him. Dr. Kenny Potter has already been in his classroom visiting since Mr. Haley has been here, as well as Mr. Bumgarner, and I've just been amazed at the things that I have seen over the past month or so. I will tell you that Ms. Humphreys is fine and going to be fine, but she did make the decision to resign from her position last week. And I'm also very pleased to tell you that as of January 2nd, Mr. Haley will be a permanent member of our staff at East Gaston. Everyone is as pleased as I am to have you. Thank you. And thank you all so much. And I hope you have a wonderful holiday season. And again, thank you for your support. We so much appreciate you. And thank you, students, for your hard work, because I'm very impressed with you tonight.
Freedom is coming, freedom is coming, oh yes I know. Freedom is coming, freedom is coming, freedom is coming, oh yes I know. Freedom is coming, freedom is coming, freedom is coming, oh yes I know. Freedom is coming, freedom is coming. Freedom is coming, oh yes I know. Freedom is coming, freedom is coming, freedom is coming, oh yes I know.